Hi everyone. If you don't have a large sunny spot to grow vegetables and think you can't have a garden, well, think again. Today I'm going to show you vegetables that you can grow in a partial shade garden in a raised bed. But first, we've got a trellis to install. We trimmed some trees, saved the branches, made this beautiful trellis, and guess where it's going? You got it, in the new mini elevated raised bed. So let's go. Camera guy and I had a great time making this trellis. We just screwed together the supports, wrapped them in twine to give it a nice pretty look, and we're gonna pop it here in our raised bed. Very excited about it. It's gonna give things a nice organic look back here. It'll be really fun to grow some vegetables and save space while we're doing it. So we'll just put it here in the back. It's nice and tall. It's about 6 feet tall. I'm gonna push it down. Can't wait to grow vegetables on it. Oh, it looks so pretty. Our new raised bed behind me gets a few hours of sun in the morning, then gets shaded by a big magnolia tree in the afternoon, gets a few more hours of sun later in the day. So all in all, it gets about 4 to 6 hours of sun a day. The key to growing vegetables in partial shade is the varieties that you plant. You've got to choose varieties that will still produce in the partial shade, partial sun situation, and also more compact varieties that don't need as much sunlight to produce. So we've got a lot to plant today. Let's get going. I've got a section of shade-tolerant vegetables in my book on raised bed gardening, so grab that. It'll be a really good resource for you. So first, what I'm going to do is lay out the veggies in the bed so we can kind of see how things are going to fit. The compact veggies are going to come first. You guys are going to love the vegetables we're going to plant today. The first one is a nice compact cucumber. It's called the Diva cucumber. It's really the prima donna of cucumbers. I have seeds for this in my Grow Your Groceries with Callie Kim May subscription box. This is a very special cucumber because it only produces female flowers. The female flowers would have the fruit attached to them. And the thing is though, it does not need bees to pollinate. It's self-pollinating. It's called parthenocarpic. It's a big word. And so if you're short on bees in your garden, you definitely want to plant some Diva cucumbers. So those are going to be the thrillers. They're going to climb up the trellis. It's going to be really pretty to save space with this trellis. It'll look really, really nice. Now, another compact vegetable that I absolutely love is a tiny Tim tomato. So if you have a partial shade garden, you might not think you can grow tomatoes, but you definitely can. The tiny Tim is a smaller dwarf variety, and it's a determinate tomato, so it's perfect to plant in a smaller space in this partial shade garden. Small tomatoes, but produces a ton, and it will grow beautifully here in the garden. The other thing I'm going to pop in here are some spillers. Now, the spillers are things that kind of spill over the sides of your garden bed, make it look really pretty, and save space because they're spilling. And this one is a round zucchini, and it's a smaller, more compact variety of zucchini. Smaller zucchini is about the size of a baseball, so it's perfect to grow in your shade tolerant garden. We've got some of our compact vegetables all laid out. The second crop you can plant in a partial shade garden are herbs. Some herbs don't tolerate full sun. Basil is one of them. It's one of my very favorite herbs. It loves the heat, but it doesn't like to get super overheated. And I love this basil. It's called the Prospera Compact Basil. This was in my April Grow Your Groceries with Callie Kim subscription box. Nice compact variety. The beautiful thing about this basil is that it's downy mildew resistant. Downy mildew can really wipe out your basil. So love this variety, especially for a partial shade garden. The next crop we're going to plant in our partial shade raised bed are bunching onions. Now, bunching onions aren't like normal onions. They're more like green onions. They don't have big bulbs, so they're perfect to plant in a spot where you don't get tons of sun. And these are really unique bunching onions. They're purple bunching onions. These are in my April pizza garden box. Can you see the little tiny purple bulbs on them? They're so beautiful. I absolutely love them. They're going to make nice little fillers here in our raised bed too. We've got our compact veggies, we've got our herbs, we've got our bunching onions. The next crop we're going to plant here, which are perfect for partial shade, are greens. Grow your greens in partial shade. They will really benefit from the extra shade that it gets here. Now, the greens I'm going to plant are from my specialty green seed collection. We've got some endive here, one of my very favorite greens. These are going to fill in the empty spaces of the garden bed too. And we have some arugula. This is from the fall garden seed collection. Super, super quick growing green. These are both cool weather greens, but they do tolerate some warmer temperatures, so they'll be perfect to plant here in the late spring. As summer comes on, we'll plant some heat tolerant greens in here. We'll have a nice garden bed full of all kinds of salad toppings for our dinner plate. We've already got our fertilizer added in here. We've installed our drip irrigation. We are ready to plant. So first, what I'm going to do is just plant the little Diva cucumber back here in the corner. This is in a cow pot, which will biodegrade in the soil. The roots aren't restricted, and it really does, the little pot really does break down quickly. So you don't even have to take the cucumber out of the pot. Just dig the hole, pop it in, which is perfect for cucumbers because they don't like to have their roots disturbed. So just pop it in the hole. You can see I've got two little cucumbers in this pot here, which is perfectly fine. Cucumbers like to grow close together. Then they kind of intertwine and make the plant a little bit stronger as they climb up the trellis. Backfill it with a little bit of soil. We are good to go with that. I'm going to plant the other two cucumbers in the exact same way. These are spaced here about a foot apart, just to give them all space to climb up over the trellis. Next, we're going to dig a hole right in the middle of the garden bed for Tiny Tim, one of my very favorite tomatoes. You can grab seeds from my Container Garden Seed Collection, a great collection if you're growing in a small space. And this Tiny Tim was actually growing inside during the winter time. I brought it outdoors, and now it's ready here for its permanent home. What goes better together than tomatoes and basil? So I'll plant my tomato here in the same way. The cow pot right next to Tiny Tim. Got our squash here. I'm actually going to move this round zucchini over to this side. I'll just plant one spiller for now. Dig a hole, pop it in. And you can see here how there is a little flower here. I'm actually going to pinch that off because I want all the energy to go into producing the green leaves right now, not into producing fruit. So we'll pop the round zucchini in here. And this does go to harvest in about 60 days or so. So it's a nice quick producing veggie. You are gonna love it. Now the bunching onions, I'm actually gonna break apart and plant in bunches. We'll have be able to have two little bunches here in the garden bed. Onions are very, very resilient, very tough plants. So definitely no problem. The roots are gonna be just fine. And you will absolutely love this variety. And grab yourself one of my Grow Your Groceries with Callie Kim subscription boxes for $7 off your first month with the code GROWYOURGROCERIES over at CallieKimGardeningHome.com. Everything you need to grow an edible project is all in the box for you. You're going to absolutely love it. So we'll plant one bunching onions here on this side of the garden bed, another one over by the basil. I love seeing these roots. They're just so pretty. You want to leave the top of the onions kind of sticking out just a little bit. So I'm going to peel back the cow pot. So leave the top of the little purple bulb sticking out a little bit. Now along the front of the garden bed here, we're going to plant some seeds for some greens. I'm going to pop in here my endive. Super beautiful, roughly little green here. Super tasty. Just sprinkle the seeds here along the drip irrigation. Sprinkling a little bit of soil over here, kind of tamping it down a little bit. Now it's time for the arugula seeds, one of the quickest growing greens there is. Super delicious, has a nice little peppery flavor. You're gonna love growing arugula in your partial shade garden. You can also plant it underneath the shade of some cucumbers or tomatoes in your regular full sun garden, just to give it a little bit of shade as it grows, but it's gonna be perfect here in this spot. Now it's time to water and feed our plants. Now I know I do this in every video, but it is very important to make sure your plants have the moisture they need and the food they need to really get off to a good start. First up is the fish fertilizer, higher in nitrogen, so really gives your plants a nice little boost of just lots of green growth and lots of good leaves as they're starting out. Add some to my watering can here. Now I'm going to mix in some of the Vermistera Vitality. It's really gentle and safe for your plants, never burns them. It just provides a nice, good, slow and steady growth and helps improve the nutrient absorption of the fish fertilizer so you don't have to use near as much on your plants. Now we have such a big problem with earwigs and pill bugs. I never plant anything without putting down the Bonide Bug and Slug Killer. We're working Bonide on this video as well. Absolutely love this stuff. It's super easy to apply, safe for organic gardening. You just sprinkle down the pellets, and what happens is the pill bugs are attracted to the pellets and they go towards those instead of your vegetables. and it kills them so they don't eat your seedlings. Nothing more frustrating than coming out here and seeing all your newly planted seedlings just chowed down. Definitely does the trick. Last thing is to add some mulch. Now I'm using shredded leaves for my mulch here, but you can also use shredded straw or pine needles. Mulch is always very important to add when you're planting because it protects the soil from drying out. Also protects it from the heat or the cold, depending on what season you're in. And I like to just put down a light little layer when I first plant. That way the seeds don't have any issues germinating. Then you can always go back later and add a few more inches as the season progresses. I'm very excited to have this raised bed planted up. This is my very favorite raised bed design from my book on raised bed gardening. Head over to CallieKimGardenAndHome.com, grab the book. You can grab my raised bed kitchen garden seed collection. The seed book bundle is $5 off. I'll put links to everything I use in the video description. You'll also want to grab one of my Grow Your Groceries with Callie Kim subscription boxes. $7 off your first month with the code GROWYOURGROCERIES. Comment below and let me know if you're going to be planting up a partial shade garden or if you're building this elevated raised bed. I would love to hear about it. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you on the next video.